Coming up on today's episode. All right, well, we are back on the Sony CFD-510. This is the CD player mechanism removed from the basically the chassis from it. One of the things we wanted to check was this switch here, S703. I don't know where you can see that, but that is 703 right there. This is the limit switch. Basically, when the head or the lens, and this is the lens here, moves down, as you can see it moving down, and once it gets down to as far as it goes, it clicks that switch and makes the motor stop. So that's what makes the motor stop. And that's working. I have checked it with the meter, and when it's closed like that, or when it's all the way against it, it is closed. And as soon as it pulls away from that and releases the tension, it opens up. That's really all it does. So there is no problem with that. I was thinking maybe this was a little bit, the grease might be sticky or something of that sort. But I don't think so. If anything, it moves pretty good. And it's, you can see the white lithium grease on there. It's still got that on there. I do have a little bit of a looseness here with this switch on that cog there, and I can make it kind of strip once in a while. I don't think that's a big problem. I think the motor just moves again if it slips and keeps going until it finds what it needs. It's not a terrible problem. There's no missing teeth that I can see, but it's just we can see how this moves back and forth. There's just a little looseness to it, and I don't think there's any adjustment for that. I believe that is just, is what it is, as they say. Now, that area in here is also looks like it's got plenty of lithium grease on it. These should be fairly good for these to contact these, and this part is good, but I don't know about the other. See, that looks good, but see, it's just when I move it over a little bit that way, now if I put it there, it runs real fine. There's no missing teeth or nothing like that, so that's not the problem there. I don't know about this gear in here, but it seems to be okay. Like I said, as long as I keep pressure on it and move it as it should be moved, it doesn't seem to slip. So I'm going to say that's not the problem. Now, I've watched a lot of videos on CD mechanisms and some of the other problems besides the limit switch and cleaning. That's the lens, in case you didn't know. And like I said, you have to clean that with a cotton swab and some alcohol. Really good. Make it shiny, and it's pretty good and shiny right now. But one of the other problems is this spindle doesn't spin fast enough. Now, I don't know. You know, that's a problem with this motor here, and I don't know that that's something I care to fix. Now, these mechanisms, I believe, are available. I know one of the videos that I watched said they are available from China, and the guy replaced one of his, so I'm assuming they are. This top cover here comes off, and I think some of the parts you just replace yourself. The cover here and some other things that you replace. But, you know, if this little venture here, you know, basically I was going to clean it, but it really doesn't need cleaning. I mean, there's a little dust here and there, but nothing that would keep it from working. So, you know, I don't know. I'm going to, before I put it back together, I'm going to clean that lens again while I've got it all out here and away from everything, make sure that it is really clean. And so once I do that, now, again, this seems to spin just fine. There's been some reports that this area here needs cleaning, and it does feel a little rough. I don't know how rough, but that has problems gripping the disc, I guess. And so that's one of the other areas that need to be cleaned, as well as the one on top of the machine, which is up in here. And that one, it's the same way. I think that one just basically puts, it's like a weight, and it just puts pressure onto the CD to make it adhere to the bottom. And I think that's all that that does. So, anyway, I'm going to clean this. I might put some of that super lube on some of this, but again, I don't think it needs, it's working. It's working just fine. It moves back and forth like it should. You can, it's feeling, you can feel the motor turning when you do that. I mean, that's the only thing that's holding it. It's the mechanism itself. If this gear here wasn't here, that thing would spin back and forth real free. I mean, it would go back and forth, and you wouldn't like nobody's business. So, anywho, that's that. Again, I think that's about it. These seem to be nice and supple. These get dried out and hard, but them are very nice. And so I took a picture of this, make sure I get this back in the right way. So, anywho, that's that. I think what I'm going to do is, again, clean this section here. Double check everything here, the lens, make sure that it's good and clean. And try to put it back together and see what happens. If it works, it works. If it don't, you know, I might look into seeing how much these are. I believe the guy that, of course, now he was, I believe, in the UK, but he replaced it. It was 13 pounds, so many pence, whatever that, 1334, I think he said, but it wasn't that much. He got his on Alibaba, or AliExpress, I should say. So anyway, like I said, all this stuff is usually available. And this is no exception. But I figure, you know, if there's a problem with it, we should be able to fix it, I would think. But anyway, like I said, this motor may not be spinning fast enough. That was his problem. He said this wasn't spinning fast enough to get red. And so that's maybe a problem. I don't feel any, you know, with this motor over here, you can feel a lot of resistance when you move that back and forth. I feel nothing at all with this. So... I do know that motor spins because I've seen the disc spin inside, but like I said, whether it's doing it as it should do it, I don't know. But I'm going to sit that all the way out. Well, not all the way, let's put it right there. Because what that first should do, what I understand, is this should be, actually, it moves into the center first. And then it should focus the lens on the CD, and that's more or less where you get your information from. While the disc is, or then it spins up the disc, and then it reads the, you know, information from the disc. So as far as I can tell, it goes to the center and doesn't do anything. Now that may be a focus problem. I don't know. That's a possibility. But whatever it is, I thought this one was the easiest one to get to. This is the CFD-510, and it just popped out pretty easy. It almost fell out. But like I said, I thought we would check this because, you know, these Sonys are all going to be just about exactly the same. So I figure if we can find a problem with this one, then, you know, that gives us a head start on the rest of them. So that's my thought on it. You know, you guys may not share that, I don't know, but, you know, so. Anywho, there's my first look at that, and we're going to do what I said I was going to do, and then we'll come back and see if it fixes it. All right, we have it all back together now, and enclosed, and it's all the wires are hooked up and everything, and I've got it tentatively hooked up here to where it might work. Let's see if we can put it in. It's in tape mode now. That's basically off. There's radio. Radio's working just fine. Let's go to CD. I see it's doing something. It looks to be... it is reading. It's got 26 tracks. 7250 is the time. Let's see what we can get. This is going to be neat. Hit the play button. And I got to hit it better than that. There it goes. Oh, yeah. There you go. There's track two. I think the controls are a little dirty.
When you just give love.
Volume control is a little dirty too.
You better let love
get you a little bit better shot of it. Display.
I know some, and yet I know I can get my heart. Sometimes I'm weak and I think I won't. Sometimes again
it's hard to get that next track because of the nut behind her. There's stop, and you can see there's the full track reading. It is working. So basically, you saw what I did, or I told you what I was going to do, and I did exactly what I said I was going to do. I cleaned the lens one more time, really good. I cleaned that platter turntable thing and cleaned it off really good, and even cleaned the upper one too. So you can see it is working. Most of these can be done, you know, fairly easily. After you discover there's no real problem, the limit switch was working as it should. And like I said, it is working now. So, very happy about that. So, there you go. That's it. That's all we're going to do for this evening. And I think that was enough. I just thought while I was waiting on the parts for the MP3 or Bluetooth module, I thought, well, it'd be a good idea to... This came out so easy, and it was easy enough that I can work on the other ones now, I think, with no problem, and hopefully get those working as well. Usually there's not too much wrong with these. There's not a lot to go wrong with them, so let's turn that off. And that's... Yeah, see, there's radio in the middle. So that's working. Now just get the
41.
Current temperature is 55 degrees.
So I did discover some more things. I've gotten some comments on the tape problem. And there is an idler wheel on this that has a rubber, lack of a better term, rubber baby buggy bumper or something like that. And it actually drives the spin reel, or the take-up reel, whatever you want to call that. And I've got it here in the bag. It fell out when I was working. And I think I may have shown this already, but there it is right there. And, or what's left of it. It's cracked and broken, and like I said, there's not really much to it. But that's the reason it doesn't, the reel doesn't take up like it should. And so the belts are, you know, one thing, but that's another thing completely. So he pointed that out to me, and I, it wasn't a half hour later than I got in here and was starting to work on it again, seeing that laying on the bench. And I thought, well, that must be what he's talking about. And sure enough, it was. So I'll put his handle in here, his channel name, and so you can check him out. He does a lot of stuff like this. And so... Anywho, that's that. But like I say, if it's going to take a long time for the rest of that to get here, I might play around with that cassette player. I don't know. Don't really need the tape in there. I had the tape in there. But like I said, getting that CD player working was a big load off my mind, because like I said, I never really had one before that you couldn't just clean the lens on it and it didn't work. So. All right, that's going to do me. Like I said, you guys have a good one, and we'll talk at you later.
The sun burns a hole through the 6 a.m.
All right, well, there is a quick listen to some Brian Wilson, Lucky Old Son CD. That is a CDR, and I wanted to make sure those played as well in the little Sony CFD-510. And it seems to work just fine, and I'm happy about that, very happy. So we'll stop that there. And like I said, I don't know how many of you know this, but I made up a little sign. I saw one on Facebook, something similar, and it had obviously different letters. And I decided, I think I'll just see if I can alter that a little bit. And I thought that turned out pretty good. So like I said, I may try to make me a sign up for that and print it out or something and put it up on the bench or put it up on the pegboard or somewhere. Anywho, that's that. Let me zoom you in down here a little bit. And what we have here is mail items. Yeah, you guys remember the mail, don't you? Been a while. The first one I'm going to show you is the... now, I don't know when this was delivered. I didn't get any tracking on this. Like I said, the tracking went blank, basically. And, you know, it was only good until a certain point. Now, this is the little Bluetooth module that is for the GE radio. Some of you guys may remember that. And what I'm going to do, probably, is go ahead and start working on cutting the face out of that so I can mount this on there. And once I get that done, then we'll go ahead and do the rest of it. Obviously, not too much to do as far as that's concerned. It does have a remote in with it. I haven't checked to see if there's a battery in it yet, but it does have a remote there. I think you can see that. So, but anyway, that's finally got here. And I am going to go ahead and work on that some. Like I said, once it came in, I may just go ahead and break off of the boom boxes and go back on to the GE, because it was actually project first before the boom boxes became a thing. So we'll set that off here. All right, the other item that came in was the module in a box. So you guys may remember, I posted some pictures of that. This is the device that came in. It's a lot larger than I thought it would be, but, you know, is what it is. I may try to put some sticky tape on the bottom of this and stick that on top of the player. That might be the way to, on top of the boombox, I should say. And that might just be the way to do that. But I am going to, as I said, get a 3.5 millimeter stereo jack, and or a plug, I should say. And I'll have, I'll actually have the cables here at the bench, but like I said, I may go ahead and put one of those on the back of the boombox itself to onto the same place I've got this hooked up, which is the CD input. I think that's where we're going to try to put that into, and that should work just fine. It also has a remote and has a... I'm not really sure what that is. Oh, that's just a charging, or not charging. Well, I'm not really sure. That must be power, I guess. I'm saying that's what that probably... Yeah, there's power. Okay, that's what that is. That's the power. So anyway, that's that, and that's good. Like I say, everything's working out rather well here, I think. There was something else I had, and I wanted to share that with you as well. Now I have forgotten what it is. I think what I'm going to do on this... we'll turn you around here a little bit. On this CFD-510, I think I'm going to go ahead and remove the cassette drive mechanism like I did on the, I believe it was the Iowa. I believe I removed that one. Put it in a bag and then storing it with the, actually the boombox wherever I put it. I can't even remember where I put it, but it is somewhere. But anyway, so like I said, it is progressing pretty good. I'm enjoying what I'm doing here. I'm enjoying my little boombox. I got boomboxes on the brain. I'm enjoying my little camera boom. And again, that's working out really well. It allows me to get a lot of different places I couldn't get before. I mean, you know, I can basically see anywhere I want to with this, and I think that's just a much better situation, at least to me it is. And so that's what I'm doing. So, all right, that's it. I'm gonna see if I can think of what else I was gonna do, and we'll go from there. But again, I wanted to let you know what I got in the mail. Oh yeah, I know the other thing. I went to the doctor today. I don't know. I don't want to be like some people and just go over every one of my troubles. Basically, it was just the 6 months checkup. You know, I had my blood work done last Friday. Everything's fine with it. Numbers are good. And, you know, I was telling my daughter that doctor says I'm feeling good. So I said, well, that's news to me. But like I said, it is. I can't complain. I'll make jokes about it, but like that. And that's the other thing. Also, Sky Carl, on his little video update, and very, very pleased to see Carl. I hope he's able to go through with his plans to make some more videos and stuff. And if I can help any way at all, Carl, and you know, on subject matter, whatever, you know, I'm here for you, man. So, like I said, I like Carl, and I forgot to mention it, Carl, on your video. I saw your cat in the background there. I believe it was your cat trying to get in on the video. So, I think that's nice to have a good pet like that. So, all right, that's gonna do me. Like I said, I blah 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 blah. Watched Bill's coffee flap this morning. It was good. And always glad to see Bill, too, you know. You guys, us old guys, you never know from one week or the other if we're going to see us again or not. It's always kind of a mystery, you know, when we don't come around. That's the way it was with Carl, and he hadn't shown up on video for so long. I had a couple of people ask me about it, and I have his email, so I emailed him and asked him if everything was all right, and he told me he was going to be making a video, and so anyway, he has now, and everything's fine. Hunky-dory, as they say. And I hope everything goes well with his little medical procedures and stuff. And, you know, that's a modern miracle of science, I hope. And so, all right, I know I'm blathering. So let me get off here, and we'll get something else cooking.